Hey everybody, and welcome back. Welcome back everybody to my YouTube channel. If you haven't watched my first video, make sure you go do that, like it, and subscribe to my channel.
Let go of your pride. Do it now, just do it now. Oh yeah. When that nigga pull up on me, tell that nigga baby, don't you know all of it.
So by the title of this video, y'all know that this is about my first semester at the Johns Hopkins University. My first semester at Johns Hopkins University as a freshman was very eye-opening. Very eye-opening.
So, okay. Me going in high school, middle school, everything, I never studied. Like, never.
Can't not study in college, period, but you especially cannot not study at Johns Hopkins. It's not going to
work. So, the first thing that I'm going to talk about is the academic standpoint of my first semester. So, as you know, and as I previously stated, I go to Johns Hopkins University. Now, this is an Ivy League level school. It's not Ivy League status, but it is an Ivy League level school. Ivy League level school. And so I struggled, okay? Like, as I said before I went to college, no study habits. Failed my first few tests, midterms at that. And got that together. Enough about my academic struggles. I want y'all to know that my first semester was not all bad. It was a lot of learning experiences, but it wasn't all bad. So I'm gonna move on to extracurricular activities. I don't know why I wrote activities. It's really only one activity. I joined the cheer team in September. So going into the tryout process, I was really intimidated. Let me tell y'all the last time I cheered. When I was 5. I am now 18, about to be 19 in February. My birthday is February 1st. Okay. So I'm about to be 18. I'm about to be 19. Like, it's been 14 years since I've cheered. So I was really nervous, but I was like, I don't want to do sports because it's too time consuming. And that's one thing that I thought of, like, even applying, which is why I didn't, like, indicate that I wanted to. And then another thing that I didn't want to do was dance. I tried out for dance, but it was right after a rugby practice. Let me tell you, I did not know what rugby was before I went to rugby practice. Rugby is basically, like, well, in my opinion, it seemed like it was, like, a girl version of football. Like, as soon as I heard the word tackling, I was like, no. Like, I don't know if y'all know this, but I am small. I'm small. Let me show you. I am small, okay? I'm 5'2½", and I don't weigh that much. So I'm like, who's gonna be tackling me and why? And then, like, they saw that I was fast. So they're like, oh, well, you could be this, and that position, but I had already made up my mind. I'm like, I'm not doing this. So, yeah, rugby was a no-go. And then after practice, I was sore. So the next day I had dance tryouts and I was freaking sore. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't even do the splits. And I can do the splits, but I couldn't do the splits. And we had stretch before. Even stretching was, well, of course stretching is painful, but stretching, I was like showing that it was painful. They were probably like, this girl can't even stretch. How's she gonna make the dance team? So yeah, needless to say, I didn't make the dance team. Which was a good thing for me, though, because I feel like cheer is fun. More fun. Sorry, Avina. Avina's my roommate. Oh, I gotta tell y'all about Avina. That's the next section. Okay. Anyway, so I made the cheer team. And going in, I was really intimidated because I hadn't cheered since I was 5 years old. So, and I cheered for the Texans, the Little League team in Texas. I think it's in Dallas. I live in Dallas, so I think it was in Dallas. I'm not sure. Yeah, I don't know. Anyways, I cheered for Little League. So going in, like, people was like, oh, I've been cheering since high school, or I cheered all of high school, or I've been cheering since middle school. And I was looking around like, how am I gonna make the team? And so, but obviously, I mean, I was in band, and I was on dance committee, so I helped make up dances. I'm quick to catching on stuff. And I caught on to the tryout was hitting really fast. My cousin, Crystal, I don't know if she's gonna watch this or not, but shout out to you, Crystal, because she was in gymnastics, like, while we were in high school. And I would go to, like, the trampoline parks and stuff with her, and she would literally make me, like, jump. And, like, make me do toe touches, make me do herkies. And she was also on competitive cheer, so when she needed somebody to go to the trampoline park, I was her person, sadly, but gladly. And so she even, like, taught me a back handspring, but then I got scared to do it again, so I haven't done it since. But the point is, like, I had been doing it kind of, not, like, under professional supervision, but, like, I was doing it. And so, like, when it came to the jumps and stuff, I guess my jumps were pretty high because I made the team. And it was weird smiling throughout the whole thing because I was a marching band in high school and I was a drum major for my last year, and we could not smile. Like, that's one of the first things they told me as a freshman, do not smile at the competition. Like, do not smile. But, you know, in cheer, that's all we have to do is smile. So I was like, okay. so I made the cheer team. And that was really beneficial for me because, number one, it brought so many more friends into my life that I didn't have before. And let's just be honest, when I first came, I was only hanging with black people. And it's not like a prejudice type thing. The only reason I was doing that was because before we even got there, we had a black group. It was a Snapchat group called Black Jays. So before we even got to school, I was already like communicating for black people. And then when we got there, they're like, oh, we're gonna hang out, or we're gonna do this. And then as soon as, like, we went to orientation week, we met some of the people in the chat. We're like, oh, are you so-and-so? Are you so-and-so? And they're like, yeah, hey, girl. And so, like, we've just been hanging out since the beginning. So it was good and fresh to have, like, new people diversify my friend group. And on top of that, it kept me, like, active. I love to be active. Like, it doesn't matter. In middle school, I did every single sport. Volleyball, basketball, track, cross country. When I was little, I did ballet, tap, swim, soccer. Like, I just love to be active. And high school, I did marching band, but shoot, that was active. That was very active. And so I got to college, and I'm like, I have to find something. And so gladly, cheer is my outlet. And I love cheer now. I love doing stunts on the flyer. I mess up a lot because I'm still kind of new at it, but they understand and they say that I catch on quickly. So, you know, now we're just one big happy family and I love cheer. And so that's my extracurricular activity, and it doesn't interfere with my academics at all. Practices are on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 to 9. From 7 to 9 o'clock, I probably wouldn't be doing, like, studying anyway. I'd probably be doing something else with my time. So that just, it focuses my time. It gives me, like, it helps me with my schedule because I'm like, okay, I know from 7 to 9 on Tuesdays and Thursdays, I'm going to be cheering. So that means I need to do work before and or after. And sometimes it's not even a lot of work. You know, sometimes it might just be looking over some notes or studying. And on Sundays, we have practice from 2 to 5, roughly from 2 to 5. It's 3-hour practice. And then Saturdays we have games. So yeah, it's really organized. It doesn't really interfere with anything. And I also, like, bi-weekly, our Black Student Union on campus meets. And when I remember I go, sometimes I forget. Sometimes I would just be coming from practice, because sometimes the practice gets moved to like 3 to 6 or something. And like the meetings are at 6:30. So, like, if I remember, I'll go. But they meet bi-weekly, and it's actually really informative. It's not a waste of time at all. They talk about really important stuff. I remember one meeting, we talked about, like, sexual assault and, like, how our school handles it and stuff. So, it's, like, it's really informative, like, being at the school. And then, like, they tell us, like, who was the first, like, black person to be accepted into Johns Hopkins. Like, it's just a lot of information that is useful and stuff that everybody needs to know, but especially black people on campus. Okay, third section. Social life. Third section is social life. And so, first of all, friends. As soon as I got on campus, I made friends. Like, when I tell y'all, I was so nervous. Like, I would tell my friends at home, like, what if, like, they don't like me? What if they don't want to deal with me? Because I know my friends deal with me. Well, I mean, we're friends, but, like, sometimes they be dealing with me because I am difficult sometimes. And I know I'm difficult, but I still love everybody. So, they love me. And anyways, I thought I wasn't going to make friends. It's like, theoretically or hypothetically, I don't know which word to use because I'm not really thinking right now. I'm on break. But I knew that I was going to make friends, but just not right away. And I didn't want to be lonely because I'm not the type to want to be lonely. Unless I'm in a bad mood, I'm like, leave me alone. But I don't want to be lonely. And so I had already been talking to my roommate before we even got there. So my roommate is Alina. Her name means that she was born on a Tuesday. So sometimes I call her Tuesday. In my phone, her contact name is Tuesday. And I've been talking to Alina like since before we even went to school. Cause first of all, we had to like choose where we wanted to live and things like that. And so, I had been talking to Alina. So when I finally met her in person, like it was like, oh, hey girl, hey. And she says it a lot. So now, I don't know, that was my first time saying it ever. And just talking about her, I guess, made me say it, I don't know. But anyways, and so when I met her in person, she was already with our other friend, her name's Autumn. And she was also in the Snapchat group chat. So like those two were like my friends, like my basically my only friends. Cause like everybody else was like, okay, hey, I recognize your name from the group chat, but we're not really like friends, you know? So those two were my actual friends. Like we hung out all of the time. Like when I wasn't with one, I was with the other. Or we was all three together. Like it was like we was always together. And then I made the tier team. I mean, and of course I met people along the way. I met my other friend who's now my like sis, like that's my boyfriend, like we besties. I met my other friend Maya at a party before we was even like friends. Her and her other friend named DR. I met those two at a party. And like, we was like, oh, hey. But then I made the cheer team and Maya's also on the cheer team. And now like, we besties. Like, I hang out with her a lot, like a lot. And so, yeah, I made friends off the bat. And then as I like continued to just like meet people in class and like, you know, pass people all the time, eventually be like, hey girl, I see you again, okay? And yeah, then I made the cheer team. So now I just have friends. I have like actual friends. Parties. So I love parties. Like I just love to dance. I love to dance and I like to listen to music. So parties are my scene. And of course there's things at the parties, but you have to learn how to like manage that. Of course you don't go, okay, now I will admit I went to a party on the school night. I did go to one party on a school night. It wasn't even a party, it was a game night. I went to game night on a school night, but then I went to class the next day. And it was a game night on a Thursday, and I know I only had one class that I had to wake up for in the morning. So after that 9 o'clock class, I will admit that I went to sleep for a little bit. But that's okay, because I went to class. So parties are really fun. I've been to a few that have shut down on me. One, the police were like actually in the place, but I think like the only reason they be shutting down is because they're too loud, like, and then they just send us home. They don't even like say anything. So I mean, parties are fun. You get to see a lot more upperclassmen because like the way my campus is set up, I think I don't see a lot of upperclassmen. Like even my cheer team, like I've only seen like two of them in like one time each. So like I don't really see upperclassmen a lot unless I'm on that side where they take most of their classes. So like at parties you see a lot of upperclassmen. Some of them you can tell they're upperclassmen, some of them you can't. Now the thing about parties, at least in Baltimore near Johns Hopkins, is that they're in basements. Now I'm not saying this like in a disgusted way, but like I'm claustrophobic. If you didn't know that about me, I'm claustrophobic. The parties are in the basement. Now, the houses are not mansions. They're like the houses that are like right next to each other. So they're decent sized houses. They're like probably like three floors. But it's in the basement. And when you have a lot of people going to that party, it's like you can't like, It's like people dancing into you, and they don't care, first of all, because most of them be drunk. They don't care if they bumping into you. And, like, I have to be in a mood to go to a party nowadays. Like, when I first got there, I was like, oh, I'm going to go to a party. Like, this is my first few college parties. But after a while, I was like, okay, I know how parties are. And now I have to be in the mood to go to a party because I'm not going to even set myself up to be like, don't touch me. I'm going to just, if I'm in the mood, I will go. So that's how parties work here. And the very first party I went to, we were drenched when we got out, and not because it was a water party. We were sweating. It was hot. When you have all those people in the basement, small room, and they trying to dance and be extra, we came out there drenched. When I tell y'all, and then I learned like not to wear nice shoes, cause y'all, okay, another thing about me is I love tennis shoes. I wore my Prestos, my green Prestos to the party, and they got so freaking muddy. Muddy. I'm like, why is your house like filthy? It was like one house that we went to, the floor was coated in mud. And like, it was disgusting. I'm sorry, but it was disgusting. And my shoes got ruined. Oh my gosh. It was not good. So yeah, I learned not to wear like my nice shoes to parties. I learned like not to bring my purse because there's nowhere to put it and I don't want my stuff to get stolen. So I also learned that. Yeah. I think that sums up the party sequence. Another thing is I went to my first college concert. Well, I didn't go to it. It was at our school, but Aminé. So anybody that knows Aminé, he came to our school and did a concert. And it was on our beach. And we don't have a real beach. It's like a circle of grass, but it had been raining, so it was muddy. So I was smart and wore my rain boots. And I didn't know almost any of his songs. I only knew one song, and it was like, Caroline. I knew Caroline. Y'all know, bad girl. Wait. Is that the word? Anyways. Caroline. Mighty. I don't know the word. But I recognize the song. Like a Tarantino movie. I don't know. But anyways, that song, I recognize that song. But now I recognize more because he came to our school and he performed. And my friend Corey, she loves him. So like, she was like on my Snapchat, so jealous. And I'm like, girl, you could be here instead of me because I don't know any of these songs, honey. Anyways, so yeah, that was fun. It was an experience. I kind of got a little touched. I got like chilled up on by this girl. It was really uncomfortable. Like, when I tell y'all that almost traumatized me, I'm like, I can't believe that somebody just, like, touched me inappropriately. I mean, of course, I know that it happens, but, like, you know, you never think it's gonna happen to you. And when she did it, I was like, It's not even the fact that she was a girl. It was the fact that, like, I didn't tell you you could touch me. Like, don't touch me like that. This freaking sexual harassment. And it wasn't on accident, y'all. I know what y'all thinking. It was a lot of people, but it was not on accident. Like, she had came to the concert, like, drunk, high, or something. And she was, like, touching all up on me. And I'm, like, moving her. Like, I literally had to physically move. And it wasn't easy because everybody was all up on each other trying to see Aminé. It was not easy. Like, and I had to move because she kept touching up on me. And I told her to stop. Like, she didn't listen. So, yeah. But the concert was definitely an experience. It was really muddy and dirty and people were pushing. But the concert was good. Moving on. So lastly, I'm just going to talk about like how I managed like all three. Like the academics, the extracurricular, and social life. So, it took me a while. Well, it didn't take me a while because everything doesn't, like, they didn't overlap, but I did have to learn, like, when to say no to parties and just, like, chill in my room because the East Coast is cold, y'all, and, like, it got cold really, really fast, and just, like, not subjecting myself to like that kind of weather, knowing that I would probably get sick and like have to miss, like I missed classes because I was sick. I rarely ever missed class just to miss class. Like when I missed class, it was because I was sick. And I often like just email my professors like, hey, I came down with a cold, like hey this, hey that. Yeah, so it was mostly just like when to know not to go out, like in the rain. Well, okay, it was Halloween. That was a special circumstance. It was Halloween and we went out in the rain. But other than that, like just knowing when to like not go to parties. Like me and my roommate, we would just like chill at the dorm. If I say chill at the house, chill at the dorm and just watch a movie. Like we love movies, so we would just chill at the dorm and watch a movie instead of going out. You know, and that's also sometimes it was just us being antisocial. But you know, most of the time we was like, you know, we don't have to go to a party. Let's just chill and watch a movie. So yeah, just knowing like when to do that. And other than that, like knowing when I had to study versus when people were like, oh, let's go to the mall. First of all, let me tell y'all, the mall takes like an hour to get there because like on our shuttle, it keeps making stops. The mall's only like 20 minutes away, but it keeps making stops. Like we have two other schools that the shuttle runs through, Towson State University and Morgan State University. Is it Towson State? I don't know. I saw it like in my physical therapy office, the flag said Towson State, but I had only heard it being called Towson University. Anyways, those two, it runs. So like the mall is like an hour, it takes an hour to get there. So no one went to be like, nah, I have to study. Like I can't commit that much time just to go into the mall and like chilling. Cause then we'll stay at the mall for like an hour or two or three. And then we'll have to take another hour. Like that's a lot. That's almost like a fourth of a day. Yeah, like 6 hours, fourth of a day just to go to the mall. And like I could be using my time for other things. So like just knowing when to dedicate your time to extracurricular and like extra stuff and when to like just be like, no, I have to do this, I have to do that. Yeah. So that's really all for this video. Also shout out to Amira. She goes to my high school and she got in at early admittance to Johns Hopkins. So I'll see you next fall, girl. Also, make sure you like and comment on this video how your first semester college experience went, or like what college you want to go to.